There's four ways to find negative keywords for Google Ads, and adding negative keywords to your Google Ads campaigns is crucial because adding negative keywords will help you to save thousands of dollars. Because when you add negative keywords to your Google Ads campaign, you're telling Google, do not show my ad if someone types in whatever these negative keywords are, which means you're not wasting money showing your ads to people that don't want to buy your products. It'll help you to avoid wasting money on clicks that you don't want to pay for. The first technique to find negative keywords for Google Ads is keywordtool.io. This is one of my favorite free ways to find negative keywords. And what's important about this is you can find negative keywords before you ever spend a penny on Google Ads. And this will help you to find those negative keywords before you start your campaign, which will help you to save a lot of money. The second tool is the Google Keyword Planner. And this is the most common way people use to find negative keywords for their Google Ads campaigns. And I'm going to show you step-by-step how to use this tool later in this video. The third and an extremely powerful way to find negative keywords for your Google Ads campaign is by using your own data. Once you are already running some Google Ads, you can see using your own data, what ads are you running that are not resulting in a sale? And you can take that information and you can create negative keywords from that, which will help you to avoid wasting money in the future. And fourth, and probably the most powerful way to find negative keywords is using a tool called Bob's Keywords. And I'll talk about Bob's Keywords at the end of this video and show you how I use Bob's Keywords to find a ton of negative keywords that could have saved me thousands of dollars. And I'll also show you how you can use Bob's Keywords for free at the end of this video. And I'm going to show you how to use all four of these methods live in this video. So make sure to smash the like button because this video is going to save you a lot of money. The first tool we're going to talk about is keywordtool.io. And you'll go to this website and you'll type in an example of a keyword that you're targeting in Google Ads. And I'm going to use my first e-commerce company as an example for this tutorial. And for that company, we actually sold dance clothing. So I'll type in dance clothing into the search bar and hit enter. And the way that this tool works is it gives you all the auto completions that would normally be found in Google. So if we go over to Google and we type in dance clothing, you can see stores near me, store brands, shop near me. And those are all the things that come up here. Then what it does is it goes through the entire alphabet and puts the letter A and will show you all the results for the letter A. Then it shows the letter B and all the results for the letter B. So what this is doing is it's helping you to figure out when people use your keyword, in this case, dance clothing, when they search for that in Google, what are the other words that they're searching along with your keyword? And this is a very powerful way to find negative keywords. So let me show you what I would do here. So the first thing I would do is I'd look through this entire list, and anything that I think should be a negative keyword, I will click. And since we don't have a physical store, the phrase near me should be a negative phrase, because if someone's typing in dance clothing store near me, then I obviously don't want to advertise for that. Same thing with NYC. We do not have a store in New York City, so that's also something that I would want to use as a negative keyword. So I'm going to go through this and I'm going to keep looking. Dance clothing ambassador. Well, if someone's searching for a dance clothing ambassador, they're not looking to buy dance clothing, so it's probably not something that I would like to advertise for. We also don't sell shoes, so that's another negative keyword right there. And basically, I'd go through this entire list and keep adding all the negative keywords. Like right here, for instance, cheap. Well, our dance clothing isn't cheap, so anyone that's typing the word cheap into Google, I don't want to show my ad for. And eventually, once I'm done going through this entire list, I'll go here and I can copy it to a clipboard or export those negative keywords to a CSV. So already, just adding these negative keywords is going to save me a lot of money. But the next tool you can use is the Google Keyword Planner. And to find the Google Keyword Planner, you're going to go to Google Ads and you're going to go to your Tools and Settings and you're going to click on the Keyword Planner. And then we're going to click on Discover New Keywords. So the first thing we're going to put here is dance clothing as a seed keyword, as something to let Google Ads know kind of what we're looking for. I'm going to click Get Results. And then this tool gives us a ton of different ideas, different keywords that are related to the keyword that we want to target for our ads. And for instance, we have here ballet dress. Well, we don't really sell ballet clothing, so that's something that I'd want to add as a negative keyword. We also don't really sell belly dance clothing, so that's another negative keyword. This really has nothing to do with belly dancing. And then from there, I would continue to go down this list and click everything that I think has nothing to do with what we actually sell. Bear dance clothing? Well, I don't know exactly what that is, but we don't really have anything to do with bear dance clothing. And once you've found out everything that you'd like to add is negative keywords, you can either click on this more and click to add them as negative keywords, or you can copy them and paste them. Now, one important thing is I'd actually want to make the word ballet the negative keyword, and I don't really care about the word dress because we do sell dresses, but anyone searching for the word ballet probably doesn't want to come to our website, and that would probably be a waste of money for us to bid on that keyword specifically. So in that case, what I would do is I would click copy, I'd go over to the negative keywords tab, add negative keywords, and I'd paste in these words and I'd modify it because ballet is a negative keyword for us, belly is a negative keyword for us, bear is a negative keyword for us. I can also take all the other previous negative keywords that I have, copy those to the clipboard, come over here and paste them in. And again, I would get rid of all the words that don't really apply. So we have near me, NYC, ambassador, shoes, and cheap. And then once we're finished, we can click the save button. And now I want to show you an even more powerful way to find negative keywords. And you can go into Google Analytics and you'll go down to acquisition, Google Ads, and search queries. And we can use this data to figure out what people are searching for in Google that's triggering your ad that you don't want to pay for, that you don't want to show up for. And let me show you what this process looks like. So I like to go down here and I like to go show 5,000 rows. And this is going to show me a lot of different search queries. So I have a lot of different data to work with. And then I'm going to go up here to the top and I'm going to click export and I'm going to export it into a Google Sheet. Then you'll quickly want to clean up some of the data. So I just delete this little header thing up here and I scroll down to the bottom and I delete the information down here because it's not really helpful for what we're trying to do. And then I like to look at where did I spend the most money, but I got the fewest conversions. And I can see here, I spent over $1,000 advertising for unitards and made $0 from that. So not only am I gonna turn this into a negative keyword, but I'm probably also just gonna turn off this campaign because it's not working. Same thing's true with the word dance space wear. And we have a few other ones like pink leggings. I spent over $460 on pink leggings and there was no conversion. Now here's another powerful hack you can use. First thing you're gonna wanna do is freeze the top row. And that just makes it so you can start sorting the information here. And we're gonna sort the pages per session from A to Z. And this will basically show us the things that people typed into Google over here, came to the website and they weren't interested because the more pages someone browses on your website, the more interested they are and the more relevant your keyword targeting is. So then I'm gonna go through here and I'm gonna look at all the things that lead to people coming to the website and basically not spending any time on it. So you can go through all this different data and find anything that you don't want to advertise for. For instance, someone just typed in chocolate color. We've spent over $37 on people that have searched in Google for chocolate color, not chocolate color dance clothing, not chocolate color, anything like that. So this would be something that I definitely want to make an exact match negative keyword for. Now the last tool and probably the most powerful tool I'm going to share with you is called Bob's Keywords. And the cool thing is they actually have a free plan. So what you're going to do is you're going to click to sign up. I'll put a link to it down below. And then once you've signed up, you go ahead and log in. Now this tool is perfect for agencies that have lots of different clients because it's extremely easy to use. And I'm going to be showing you how to use this tool in just a second. But even if you just run your own business, you can still use this tool. First step is you're going to click on new project and you're going to go type in the campaign name. So I'm just going to call this Bee Dancewear Test. You can select a date range and you can put any comments if you want to, but then you're going to click save. And then you're going to click to add your PPC search query report. There is an extension for Google Chrome that'll help you to do this next step and to download all your data. Plus, Bob's Keywords has a complete guide showing you step by step how to get your data extracted from Google Analytics into Bob's Keywords. And I'll put a link to that guide down below. But for the purposes of this video, we're going to go into Google Analytics. We're gonna go to that same place of search queries. And something that's really important is you're gonna have to change the different categories here. So let me show you how to do that. You can actually click to edit and you can go here to change the columns that appear. And so we're gonna get rid of revenue. We're gonna get rid of e-commerce conversion. We're gonna get rid of users and bounce rate as well. And we're gonna add the metric impressions and cost per conversion. Now we're gonna go to the bottom and we're gonna click save. And now you can see that we actually have this data, cost per conversion and impression shown here. And we're going to go down here and we're going to show the number of rows back to 5,000 so that we can get as much data as possible. We're going to click up here to export And what I recommend doing is saving it as a Google Sheet again. And you're going to want to delete the header here and go to the bottom and delete all the data down below. Now, the next step is to actually take this and download it as a CSV file so you can upload it into Bob's Keywords. Then you're going to go to Bob's Keywords and add your PPC search query report, click to upload it, and click Start Discovery Process. Here you can change the name of any of the labels that you'd like to change and click Next. Then on this screen, you're going to want to make sure that all the labels map to something. Now, for instance, they don't have, at the time of recording this, transactions, but transactions basically the same as conversions for the purposes of this video, and I'm going to click Next. Now, before I show you how to use this tool, you can always add trusted keywords. These are keywords that you know are not negative keywords. These are keywords that you know that work really well for you. And to do that, you'd basically go into your analytics, you'd go into your acquisition, Google Ads, and look at your keywords that you're targeting. And you could export all these keywords and upload it into Bob's Keywords trusted keywords. Since you're bidding on those keywords, you know that those are keywords that you want to keep. You can also upload your organic search results from Google Analytics into Bob's Keywords, and it will give you even more insights on how your keywords perform in organic search versus paid search results. But for the purpose of this video, I won't add the trusted keywords. And let me show you how to actually use this tool. The way that this tool works is it aggregates all the different search queries, all the different information, and it'll take individual words throughout the different search queries and combine them together. For instance, pink here has been featured in over 144 different search queries, and we can actually see them by clicking on the magnifying glass. And you can see that people have searched for pink in all kinds of different contexts. But the interesting thing is, none of these have resulted in a sale for me. There's been over 1,289 times that someone has searched the word pink with other keywords as well, and every single time, it's resulted in zero sales for me. So I've spent a lot of money bidding on search queries that include pink, and none of them have resulted in a sale. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to click this B button, and I'm going to turn it into a broad match negative keyword. And what's cool about Bob's Keywords is if we go down here, we can actually see that if I would have put the word pink as a negative keyword, I would have saved over $1,278 just from adding that one negative keyword. Then what I'm going to do is I'm going to keep going through here and look for all the other negative keywords. For instance, the word adult, over 109 times people have searched for that, 542 clicks, that's around $500 that I've lost. So let's turn that into a broad match negative keyword as well. You can see my savings went up even higher. And Bob's Keywords has a lot of different features. I can click the filter button here, and it'll show me all the different search phrases where the word pink comes up. I can also click on this button right here, and it'll show me all the different search terms that co-occur with the word pink. And the reason that the co-occur feature is helpful is because it will show you all the other terms that can also be a strong candidate to add as a negative keyword, since they also occurred with that negative keyword. Another thing you can do is you can actually filter all your different data here. You can see I've got a lot of keywords to go through. Maybe I want to do a numeric filter and just show the results that have at least 30 clicks. So I'd click Add New, I'd go to Clicks, and I'd select greater than, and I'd put in 30 here, and click Apply Filter. Now I'm only looking at negative keywords that have at least 30 clicks associated with them, because for me personally, anything that has less than 30 clicks, I don't want to even try to find a negative keyword for. Bob's Keywords also has a bunch of other features like calculated columns. You can actually take different columns and create calculations. For instance, let's say I wanted to take the cost per click times the number of clicks. I would just come in here, I would do this, and it would give me the results, which is the total cost. And then I would see that right here. This would be the total cost for all these different keywords. You can also add negative keywords as a phrase match or as an exact match, or even turn them into a trusted keyword. And then once you're done going through all this data, you can actually export your negative keywords. And one of the benefits is when you do export your negative keywords, if you open up the file, it actually automatically formats your negative keywords in the proper way, depending on if you want a broad match negative keyword, it won't do anything with it. If you want a phrase match negative keyword, it'll put these little quotation marks around it. And if you want an exact match negative keyword, it'll put brackets here. And as I mentioned, this is a very powerful tool for seeing how certain words reappear in lots of different search queries that maybe you wouldn't be able to find on your own. And let me show you one of the biggest reasons why you should add negative keywords to your Google Ads campaign. So using Bob's Keywords, I was able to find a ton of negative keywords. I only selected 8 keywords and look at how much money I saved. And if I did a deeper dive, I could probably find even more negative keywords and save even more money. And I probably wouldn't have been able to find these just using Google's tools alone. And Bob's Keywords is a tool that's gonna make it a lot easier for you to find those negative keywords. You could take all this data and you can go through and do all kinds of Excel formulas to figure it out, but Bob's Keywords makes it a lot more user-friendly. And as I mentioned, there's a link down below. They do have a free plan that allows you to upload up to 5,000 rows worth of data. So click on the link down below to try out Bob's Keywords for free.